Hello. I know you can't see me. We're going to have a go at looking at our letters that we've done before in a different way today. We're going to play a game. So you can see the letters that we've looked at before down the side on the green post-it notes. And then next to it on the other side, we've got some toys. What I'm going to ask you to help me to do is to match the sound to the toy. So if we look at the top, what sound have we got at the top? I'm going to zoom in so you can see. This one. Can you remember this one? My turn, your turn. Well done. Can you see an animal or a toy here that begins with a G? That's it, you spotted it. It's a goat, G for goat. So I'm going to put a sparkly ribbon here from my G to my goat. There we go. We're matching them together. Let's have a look at the next sound. What have we got here? My turn, D, your turn. Well done. So let's have a look at the toys. Can you see something that begins with a D? When you see it, tell me to stop. Yes, look, there it is. It's a toy dog. So we need to put our next ribbon from the D to the dog. There we go. Let's have a look at the next one. What have we got here? Well done. My turn. Your turn. Fantastic. Let's see if we can spot anything that begins with an Well, it can't be tiger or pig. We need something that begins with an Yes, you're right. There he is. For monkey. So let's put our ribbon to match up with the monkey. For monkey. Let's have a look at the next sound. What have we got here? Well done. Can you find something that begins with a P? Tell me to stop. Yes, well done. It's P for Peppa Pig. We've got a long ribbon here to stretch all the way up to Peppa Pig. Oh, here we go, the P to Peppa. Here we go. Right, let's have a look at the last sounds. Two left, here we go. What's this one, can you remember? Well done, it's T. My turn, T, your turn. Can you spot anything that begins with a T? Yes, well done, it's the tiger. He's a snow tiger, white tiger. So let's put some ribbon from our T to our tiger. There's one sound left. And I think this creature is at the same level as our letter. Let's have a look. What sound have we got? Well done. My turn. K, your turn. And what animal have we got here? What toy? Yes, it's a little cat. K for cat. So we'll put our ribbon here. Let's check to see that we got them all correct. Here we go. So we had G for goat, D for dog, M for monkey, P for Peppa, Peppa Pig, and we had T for tiger, and K for cat. Well done. Thank you for playing that game with me and practicing your sounds. Fantastic.
That was a fun way to revise our sounds, wasn't it? I like that game. It's something that maybe you could play at home too. Now let's have a look. My little stars, let's have a look at our star words. Are you ready? Here goes. Can you remember this one? Well done, you're getting really good at these. My turn, I, your turn. Fantastic. Giving you a clue. Go on, you tell me what it is first. Your turn. Yay, my turn. No. Brilliant. Can you remember this one? You can. Go on then, your turn first. Well done, my turn. Go. And this one isn't a star word, but it's a word that I showed you last time. And it's a word that you can sound out now. It's a word we see a lot and we use it a lot too. And my turn and your turn. Brilliant. If you can recognise this word without having to sound it out, your reading becomes even better. Well done. You are doing so well with your sounds. Let's have a look at our new sound for today. Let's just turn you so that you can see the board better. I've had lots of fun with this sound. I made a kite. Would you like to see it? Here's my kite. There. And it's got the sound k on it. I know you're saying to me, but we've already done the k sound. We have. We've done the curly k. This time we're looking at the kicking k. I call it a kicking k because it looks like these bits here are a leg ready to kick a football. So kicking k. When you sound it out in a word, you don't say kicking k, you just say k. And be careful you don't schwa like I nearly did then. It's not a k, it's a k. K. Can you see my mouth is hardly moving because it all happens at the back of your mouth. Fantastic. Let's have a go at writing it. This is the capital K. I'm going to have a go at writing the lowercase k. Okay, so let's have a go. Okay, so we're going to go down. It's a tall letter, so we go all the way down, back up to about halfway. And when you get there, you do a loop-de-loop. And then you do your kick. Kick. Okay. I know that's a tricky one, so let's try it again. I'm going to try it in green. Okay, so we go down and stop. Back up to about halfway. Stop, loop-de-loop, and kick. Well done. Let's try it in another colour. So this looks a little bit like a person ready to kick because this is the sound. My turn, k, your turn. Very good. So let's see if we can write it once more. I've got my comfortable grip on my pen. Here we go. Down, up, around, loop-de-loop, and kick. There we go. So have a go. That's one that we need to practice. It's one that I certainly have to practice a lot to make sure I get my loop-de-loop and my kick. And that, making sure that I have my pencil or my pen on the paper or the board all the time when I'm making the letter. Well done. So I had a go at making a kite. Here it is. All it was made from was a piece of folded paper. I cut a line down to the edge of the paper and then another line down. I had it folded in half whilst I was doing it. Then when I opened it out, I had this lovely kite shape. And because I had these two triangles here, I decided to write capital K and lowercase k. And I did a picture of a, can you guess what that might be? Can you guess? What could it be beginning with a K? Something that you open a door with or you open locks with. Yeah, well done. It's a K, key. Does key begin with a K? It does, and it begins with this K, the kicking K. Now let's have a look. I've got a tail, and on my tail I've got some bows, but the only bows that I want on my kite are the words that begin with a k. So let's have a look at the first one. Does this begin with a k? Can you see that sound in this word? Me neither. So we're not going to have this bow. But before we take it off, let's have a read of this word. D-ig. Well done. Let's try again. D-ig. Dig. Well done. So dig. I'm afraid you've got to come off the tail of my kite. Let's keep going. I've got another one here. Can you see a k in this word? No, me neither. I can't see it either. So let's see if we can read this word before it goes. T-op. T-op. Top. Well done. Bye-bye, top. Okay, let's have a look at the next one. I'm going to put my kite over my shoulder. Can you see a k in this word? So can I. It's at the very beginning. It's the first sound in that word. So you can try this one before me. Ready? Once more. Well done. I'm going to do it with you now. Ready? K-it. K-it. Kit. Well done. You may have a sports kit that you have to take to school for PE or PE kit. So that one can stay. Let's have a look at the last one. Here we go. Can you see a kicking k in that word? I can see a k too. It's the curly one, isn't it? It's not this sound. It's not this letter. It's the sound k, but it's not this letter. So let's have a go. Ready? K, an. And can. Well done. Can. Can we keep this one on our tail? Even if it's got the k sound? It's not the same as our k for kite, is it? It's not the same letter. So we're going to say bye-bye to this one. So when you're doing your reading, just watch out to see which k you can see. Is it the curly k or the kicking k? They make the same sound, but they look different. So look out for those in your reading. So my kite has got one bow on its tail. I wonder if you guys can think of any other words or pictures and have a go at making a kite of your own to fly in the wind. See you soon. Bye. Let's go fly a kite. Up to the highest height, let's go fly a kite and send it soaring up through the atmosphere, up where the air is clear. Oh, let's go fly a kite.